using this text to encourage further beginning. And we want to begin this evening by sharing a clip from the opening of the film. I've been working on this book for over a decade. The film came along much later in the process. It started about 3 years ago. And it is very much parallel to the book, though the film is sort of different, and it has all the power the film does. The film will be shown on PBS on January 14th of next year, and you'll get a preview of the opening right now. Genocide for nearly 30 years. It's something people don't much like to talk about, and about which most of us remain dangerously misinformed. Thank you. genocide and mass murder. The phrase our understanding of genocide and mass murder is shrouded in ignorance, falsehoods, confusions, and untruths. Here, in the opening of this film, we saw a large scale truth and then a small scale truth, each equally important. The large scale truth is about the number of victims, and that genocide or mass murder is the principal problem of lethal violence in the world today. It's about war. And the small scale truth is 1 millimeter outrage shot is what it means to kill somebody, which is how it has often been done in our time and in the beginning of the 20th century, face to face. A person decided to raise his hands and strike down another, often in the most gruesome of imaginable ways, in the way that Ellie describes. We need to speak truthfully about many aspects of genocide or mass murder. We need to speak forcefully, no sugarcoating. It's a serious subject, as if I need to say that. I can't tell you this evening everything that needs to be said. To be reconceptualized or told, we need to rethink how genocides began, how they unfold, how they end, and why they end. And ultimately, what we can do about them and many things in between. And the reason we need to tell these truths and to take a very cold and clear-eyed look at genocide and mass murder is because one of the truths about it is that it is not as many people take it to be, which is overwhelming, beyond our understanding, beyond our control for Islam, as we suffer Islam, as we say, that this is just something that is overwhelming. Part of humanity, what can we do? These things just erupt. We'll not be able to think seriously about what we can do about them. So the understanding is not merely an intellectual or academic or scholarly enterprise, it is a critical one that ultimately can result in the saving of lives. We need to tell the truth about the extent of the problem we have already heard about the numbers. It's probably many more than 100 million victims of manslaughter of the perpetrators of genocide. A second aspect of that is that we have to start seeing it as the systemic feature of the international community and the modern world. People typically think of genocides, however horrifying they are, as being one-off events. This happened in Rwanda, that happened in Bosnia, it happened in Cambodia before, in faraway places. For many people, faraway places about which they don't know very much. But in fact, it's not a series of one-off events. It's a systemic problem with the international system. Genocides and mass murder systematically occur. And if we start seeing it that way, we realize that we need to have systemic and systematic responses and not treat each one as if it's something unexpected. We have to try to fix